Now, entire financial sector, especially banking sector of the world, not only India, is worried about non-performing assets for the loans issued by the banks and financial institutions. One more question is whether NPS in banks will increase during this present situation. That's the basic question. Generally, we feel that definitely NPS will increase. Why? Because of many old loans unsettled, and also there was some accommodation made between the banks and borrowers, or adjustments made from the banks to bank, and that led to postponement of classification as NPA loans of some loans. That will add additional NPA loans to the present NPA loans position. Also, there may be some defaulters or delays by the borrowers who have taken loans now after current period. They speak after out of the 100% may not be in the position to repay the loans on time, or may some percentage of borrowers may become defaulter or delay. That may lead to NPA loans. Means present borrowers also, there is a possibility that out of the present borrower also some may become, maybe 5%, 10% may become NPAs. Next, there are some cases still not classified as NPA loans for the loans given to unknown borrowers. Means there was no borrower, but borrower account is there. Borrower account opened with the branches. Loan was disbursed, but the borrower is not traceable. Means the borrower is unknown to the company. At that time, KYC norms were not followed fully, or KYC norms were neglected by the authorities. That led to unknown borrowers. Maybe the borrowers not existing, or the borrowers whose name the loans were given is not genuine. Means they are refusing that they have taken loans, the borrowers, on whose name the loans were given. That is also may lead to one more addition to the NPA loans. Next is ineligible borrowers. Ineligible borrower means the borrower is eligible for 10 lakhs, but he has been given loan of 25 lakhs. So that is additional amount will always be at risk. That risk is there that additional loan may become NPA. And also ineligible borrowers means those who are prohibited by the banking sector or guidelines issued by the banking sector, finance ministry, that these loans need not be given to some sectors, maybe wines business, maybe some other illegal business, maybe, and the loans given to such ineligible borrowers also may lead to non-performing assets. This is also one more reason that there may be increase in NPA loans. Next, the drastic situation is pandemic situation. Last year we have seen totally 1 year has been spent underproductive or unproductive in many sectors. That led to slackness of business in many sectors, especially entertainment, retail marketing, luxury marketing, luxury expenditure, hospitality. Of course, there were some sectors which are improved, maybe manufacturing, agriculture, transportation, connectivity. Those sections might have improved, but these sections whose businesses were affected a lot during pandemic situation may become NPA loans. So that is also another possibility, the loan NPA loans will increase. Next, because of pandemic situation, many business style has changed, many business modes have changed, many transactions modes also changed. Earlier people used it to go for cash transactions, now it became digital transactions. And earlier used it to be some transactions were on trust basis, now the transactions are agreement based. Means that unstable business conditions led to the effect on some businesses. That also may lead to some of the loan accounts may become NPAs. And one more pathetic situation happened is more and more loans were given to marketing section than manufacturing section. Marketing based on retail display has been affected a lot. So any loan given to luxury marketing, retail marketing, display based retail marketing is likely going to be affected because of this pandemic situation, as well as the profitability of the retail based luxury marketing is totally highly affected because of pandemic situation. Earlier also it was not good, but now this bad become worse now. So thus the loans given to such marketing underperforming borrowers also may lead to additional NPA loans. And also one more thing is, there are loans given to the borrowers, that means that they become overburdened with loans. They have to borrow to repay the interest, or they have to borrow to repay the installments. Debt trap. The borrowers came under debt trap. Maybe borrowings from the lending by the banks or private lenders also led to some of the borrowers as under debt trap. That led to the situation that they will become NPA or defaulters. Such loans also may become another problem, another additional problem to the existing NPA loans. And many of the private banks, especially private banks in India and globally also, in Indian banks also, has given more and more loans for spending to individuals, maybe for a vehicle or a house or for personal expenditure or any other loans, credit cards. All these loans are given for spending. And if the loan is given for spending, the borrower may not be in a position to earn that much to repay the loans or on commitments on time because of the market situation, as well as his income may be disturbed. But if the loan should have been given for earning, the borrower should have been able to earn and repay the installments and interest on time as per specification. Because the loans are given for spending, the borrower may not be in a position to repay the loans, and that also may become additional NPA loans. Next, there are some cases, we heard some cases, loans were given under influence, maybe political influence or higher authorities influence or relationship or any other influence, the loans were given, and that also may affect the recovery of the loans, and which may lead to NPA loans. And finally, some of the loans may be at higher authorities or at the lower authorities or to large loans. We feel that many of the loans were given carelessly, negligently, irresponsibly to the ineligible borrowers or for the business or which are not monitoring properly whether the borrowed funds has been used for the purpose of business or for diversion of funds. So that led to the major effect on the banking sector as well as the addition to the NPA loans. All this led to addition or increase in NPA loans. I think that may increase, but whatever the increase is there, that is G9. That should be correct. Whatever the NPA loans are there, that should be correct one. It should not be confusion or may not be incorrect figure should not be there. The correct figures only will make us to take some decision to take in a way to reduce the NPA loans by the individuals, by corporate or commercial organizations, or by government authorities also. See, these are some of our views about NPA loans increase, maybe possibility of increase in future also.